Hi guys, it's Leslie here with Jimra. Welcome to my Yoga Sculpt class. This is a class where you won't need any equipment. You'll just need your yoga mat, and we're going to get started in a comfortable seat today. So go ahead and sit any way you like, facing the top of your mat. Just a moment to settle in. So if you've got a block at home and you like to sit on a block, that's fine. If you want to sit with your legs crossed, that's also fine. Whatever you need to do to make sure that your spine is stretched nice and tall. So you want to have a nice long spine. And you can place your hands down onto your legs, palms facing down, and just take a moment here to let the shoulders relax down away from the ears, to close the eyes. A moment in softness and stillness here at the beginning of the practice to arrive on your mat, to land in your space, to slow down. We'll just begin with three cleansing breaths. So take a nice, slow, deep inhale. Fill your lungs all the way to the top. And when you're completely full, you can't take in any more air, go ahead and exhale all the air out the body. Get completely empty and then do that twice more. Big breath in, fill the lungs all the way up. Open mouth, exhale, sigh it out. Last one like that, big breath in, filling up. And then opening the mouth, exhaling all the air out of the body. And then we'll begin to connect to the breath here. So coming into a slower, deeper breath, Ujjayi breathing, slightly constrict the muscles in the back of the throat, seal the lips, and begin to breathe deeply in and out through the nose. So you're cultivating this nice, steady rhythm for your practice. You can keep the eyes closed if you want, really listening to the sound of your breath. And let the breath guide you as we start to move through the physical shapes. We'll just start out nice and simple with a couple of twists here. So on your inhale, sweep the arms up, and as you exhale, twist. Take your left hand to the base of your spine and your right hand to the outer edge of that left knee. Just linking movement with breath, pass back through center as you inhale, and then twist to the other side as you exhale. We'll do that two more times each side. Inhale, reach up, exhale to twist. Inhale, reach. Exhale, twist. One more each side. Inhale, up. Exhale, twist. Inhale, up. And exhale, twist. Inhale, reach up. As you exhale, plant those hands down and make your way into a tabletop pose. Shoulders over your wrists, knees in line with your hips. Make sure you've got the fingers spread nice and wide on the mat so they look like starfish, and really grip the mat with the fingertips. Draw your lower belly in and up, and we'll pass through three rounds of cat-cow. As you inhale, drop the belly, arch the spine, take your gaze up. And as you exhale, round and press the mat away. Twice more, inhale, drop the belly, arch the spine, gaze up. Exhale to round. One more time, inhale. And exhale. Inhale, come back to a neutral spine. Stay for your exhale, and then as you inhale, take your left leg back hip height and your right arm, extend it forward. Get really strong in your arm and strong in your leg. Squeeze nice and tight. And then again, we'll start linking movement to breath. So this time, take an inhale, stay. As you exhale, flex that left foot, take the leg out to the left and the right arm out to the right. Inhale, back to center, toes point. Exhale, out. Keep going. Inhale and exhale, nice and slow for four. Exhale, five, exhale, six, exhale, just two more, seven, exhale, one more, eight, exhale, pause, keep that leg lifted, plant your right hand down, little pulses up and down with that left leg for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, on one, put that left foot all the way down. I'm gonna turn so you can see me, but I just want you to walk the hands towards your right knee and stand up on your right shin for gate pose. So the left foot will be planted out to the left and you'll stand up. And then interlock all 10 fingers behind your head. Take a big inhale, tall spine. And as you exhale, we're gonna start to work that core a little bit. Hinge to the right as far as you can, keeping a tall spine. Inhale back to center, and then take a reverse warrior as you exhale, reach over. Inhale, come back, hands behind the head. Exhale to hinge and up, reverse and up. Three, up, reverse and up. Four, up, reverse and up. Five, this is halfway, reverse, come back. Six, reverse, come back. Seven, reverse, come back. Eight, reverse, come back. Two more, hinge, come up, take a reverse, come back. Last one, hinge, come up, reverse, and back. Great job. Now just slowly come forward. I'm just gonna turn back, but you're gonna plant your hands down. So you're back with the hands down. Take that left leg back, tuck your right toes, and lift into a down dog split with the left leg high. As you exhale, bend the left knee and open the hip for a scorpion dog. And just pause to breathe, stretch it out. And then as you inhale, re-straighten the leg, square off your hips. And as you exhale, squeeze your knee in to meet your nose, roll forward like a plank pose. Inhale, up and back, down dog split, left leg high. Exhale. Touch as high as you can on your left tricep, all the way up, squeeze. Inhale up and back, and now to the right tricep, exhale, squeeze it. Down dog split, we'll do that one more round through, knee to nose, exhale. Inhale up, squeeze it to the left, exhale, touch all the way above the elbow, inhale up, exhale above that right elbow, squeeze. Inhale up, now exhale, roll forward. Three limbed plank and little pulses with that left leg for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Left foot down, take an inhale, pitch forward, and as you exhale, lower all the way down, however you want to get there, onto your belly. Tops of the feet press down into the mat. Take your hands underneath your shoulders. If you can, bring your big toes together so they touch. And as you inhale, peel your chest up off of the mat. Baby cobra. Exhale, chest comes down. Two more just like that. Inhale, chest lifts. Exhale, chest lowers. One more. Inhale, chest lifts. Exhale, chest lowers. Now separate your feet a little wider than your hips if you need to. If you can, you're welcome to keep the big toes together. And then goalpost your arms and lift up your head, chest, and shoulders. Really focus on squeezing the shoulder blades nice and tight. And we're just gonna take little pulses up and down for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now add on those legs, lift them up, keep the belly nice and tight. As you inhale, reach the arms forward, and as you exhale, cactus and squeeze the shoulder blades. Keep those legs lifted. We've got 9 more, reach and squeeze. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower everything down, inhale. Child's pose, exhale to stretch it out. Remember, child's pose is always available to you at any point in time throughout the yoga practice if you need rest. It's always here for you. Let's do that other side. So on your inhale, rise back up to a tabletop pose. Stay for your exhale. I'm just gonna flip so you can see what I'm doing. And we'll start with the right leg this time. So inhale, take the right leg back hip height. The left arm reaches forward. Squeeze arm, squeeze leg. As you exhale, arm to the left and leg to the right. Inhale back. Seven. Keep the belly tight. Six. Five, four, three, two, one. Now keep it out to the right. Place the left hand down and we'll take those little pulses for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Place that right foot down, walk your hands in, I'm just gonna turn so you can see me. You're standing on your left shin and the right foot is down, pressing into the outer edge of that right foot. Belly in, tall spine. Interlock all 10 fingers behind your head. Inhale as you exhale. Hinge to the left as far as you can, keeping a tall spine. Come back to the center. Inhale, the exhale is a reverse warrior. And then up to center. 9. Reverse. 8. Reverse. 7. Reverse. 6. Reverse. 5. Reverse. Just 4 more. Hinge. Reverse. Last 3. Reverse. Last 2. Reverse. Just 1 more. Hinge. Reverse. Good job. Now plant those hands forward and you'll come back into your tabletop. Take that right leg back. Tuck your left toes. Lift up and back. Down dog split. Bend that right knee and open the hip into your scorpion dog. Get a nice stretch. And then straighten that right leg, square up the hips. Inhale here. Knee to nose. Exhale. Inhale, right leg up and back to the right tricep. Get all the way up there above the elbow. Touch it. Inhale up. Exhale, squeeze it to the left. Inhale up and back. We've got one more round. Knee to nose. All the way up and back to the right tricep. All the way up and back to the left tricep. All the way up and back, and then three-limbed plank pulses with that right leg for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Put that right foot down, find your plank, inhale, pitch forward, exhale, lower all the way down onto your belly. This time, bring your feet a little bit wider than your hips. Take your fingers outside of the mat. Peel your chest up. Inhale, exhale, chest down. 2 more. Inhale, peel the chest up. Exhale, chest comes down. 1 more. Inhale, peel the chest up. And then exhale, bring the chest back down. This time, take your arms forward and lift everything off of the mat. Take an inhale here. As you exhale, start to flutter kick those feet. Breathe, keep reaching those arms forward for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, keep the belly tight, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Put it all down. This time, hands under the shoulders, tuck your toes, pull your belly in. We're coming up to plank. Inhale, press up, plank. Exhale, we'll meet in a downward facing dog. Lift those hips up and back. Pedal out your dog, bend the right knee, bend the left knee, go for a little walk here, whatever free movement feels good in the body. Stay connected to that smooth, steady ujjayi breathing. And then when you're ready, rise high onto the balls of the feet and tiptoe your way all the way up to the top of the mat. Inhale, half lift to lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold over the legs, uttanasana. Root to rise, inhale, sweep the arms all the way up, and then exhale, bring the arms down by the sides, Samasthitihi. So we'll start into our Sun A's to really get into our warm up here. So 3 rounds of Sun A with added core work. So inhale, sweep the arms up, palms touch. As you exhale, swan dive forward, Uttanasana. Halfway lift, inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. As you exhale, step back to plank. Hold your plank. Take your feet as wide as the mat, so you've got a wide base in your plank. Tap your right hand to your left shoulder, put it down. Tap your left hand to your right shoulder, put it down. And then a jumping jack, feet together, feet wide. We're gonna keep going like that. So tap, tap, together, and wide. Tap, tap, together, and wide. Keep going. Go at your own pace. If you want to amp it up and go faster, you're welcome to. We're here for another 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Keep the core strong. 5. Arms straight. 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring your feet back to hips with distance. downward facing dog we meet. Move through a vinyasa if you want to. Lower halfway down, chaturanga. Inhale to upward facing dog. Exhale to downward facing dog. One smooth breath in. One smooth breath out. Finish your exhale completely, then rise high on the toes. Inhale, step, or you can jump, however you want to get to the top of the mat. Take a half lift, inhale, take a forward fold. Inhale, sweep the arms all the way up to the sky, and then exhale, arms by the sides. Setting up our second round. Inhale, reach, palms touch. Exhale, swan dive forward, Uttanasana. Halfway lift, inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, step back, hold your plank. We're doing 10 push-ups this time. If you need to, lower the knees down. They're chaturanga style, so you want the elbows into the ribs. One. You can do it no knees if you want to. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Belly in. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. Vinyasa is there for you. Chaturanga exhale, back bend, inhale, downward facing dog to exhale. One cycle of breath, just one. Nice slow inhale, nice slow deep exhale. And when the exhale is complete, rise high on the toes, take two steps or you jump, top of the mat, however you want to get there. Half lift to inhale, fold on the exhale. Root to rise, sweep those arms all the way up to the sky, and then exhale, arms by the sides, Samasthitihi. Last round of Sun A. Inhale, reach up, palms touch. Exhale, swan dive, Uttanasana. Halfway lift, inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, step back, hold your plank. This time, you're going to take that right knee across, left hand behind the head, back to plank. Then the left knee across, right hand behind the head, back to plank. Keep going just like that. So you'll seal your back foot down as you do that twist open. Keep going. We're here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, move through your vinyasa or skip it. You can always skip the vinyasas and press to down dog. It's your practice. Once you reach the down dog, it's just one breath in, one breath out. Finish your exhale, then inhale, rise high on the toes. Take two steps or jump, top of the mat, land in your half lift. Fold as you exhale. Rise as you inhale, sweep the arms up, palms touch. Exhale, arms by the sides, Samasthitihi. Hands to your hips. You can either step or maybe you jump the feet to the width of your mat. Take your toes out a little bit, hands in prayer, and sit all the way down into a Malasana squat. So we'll pause here just a moment to breathe. Dig your elbows into your inner thighs. Keep the belly tight. All right, from here, we're going to start getting a little bit more movement in. So I want you to start from this Malasana and then stand all the way up, arms by the sides, optional calf raise at the top, and then all the way back down as low as you can go into your Malasana, keeping the belly in and a tall spine. Let's go. So let's go, stand up, sit low, up and down. Keep going, up and down, up and down for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Meet me in a Malasana. Walk those hands behind you. Sit your hips all the way down and find a boat pose. Now, if you need to modify in your boat, hands by your hips, knees bent, maybe you're in between, float arms forward. Those of you that really like the spice, you straighten your legs. Take a breath in, down to a low boat, and as you exhale, scissor your legs all the way up, all the way down. Inhale, And then exhale as a high boat. We're gonna keep going. Inhale, low boat. Exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale up, high boat. Let's keep going. Inhale, low. Scissor switch up. Scissor switch down. Exhale, high boat. Two more rounds. Inhale, low boat. Exhale, scissor switch up. Inhale, scissor switch down. Exhale, high boat. Last round. Inhale, low boat. Exhale, scissor switch up. Inhale, scissor switch down. Exhale up, high boat. Now inhale to low boat. Listen. Exhale, both legs up. Lower your left leg down. Take a steeple grip with your hands. Inhale. As you exhale, twist outside of your right leg. Only the right leg moves. 10 times. Let's go. Down and up. 9, 8. Good job. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale to center the hard way. Exhale, right leg down. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, twist. I know this is hard, you guys. This is the last. 10 times, down and up with just the left leg. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, woo, 2, 1. Oh, hug the knees into the chest. Great job. Get those abdominals working. All right. One more little thing here. Hug those knees into the chest, and I want you to use the belly muscles to rock up and back. And you're gonna rock up to chair pose, and then you're gonna rock back. And we're gonna do this for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, you got it, keep going, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, meet me in chair. Let's pulse it out. 10, weight is in the heels. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fold forward, Uttanasana, good job. Halfway lift, inhale. As you exhale, heel toe your feet, hips width distance. Take your peace sign fingers and hook your big toes. Halfway lift, inhale. Fold as you exhale. Slow the breath down if you lost it. For any reason, back to Ujjayi, and really pull on your toes. Let the head and neck be heavy. Shoulders away from the ears. Use your strong arms to help you lengthen your spine. Last exhale. As you inhale, halfway lift, release your toes. And as you exhale, step back and find that plank pose again. Get really strong in your plank, and then just start to shift forward and shift back. Forward and back for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Grip with the fingertips. 4, 3, 2, 1. Move through your vinyasa or skip it. We'll meet in downward facing dog. All right, reset the breath in your downward facing dog, and then we'll move along. As you inhale, lift your right leg up in a down dog split. As you exhale, three-limbed plank. As you inhale, down dog split. As you exhale, knee to your nose. We're doing that 4 more times. Down dog split. To three-limbed plank, to down dog split, knee to your nose, 3 more. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, 2 more. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, 1 more. Inhale, exhale, inhale, and exhale. Good job. Inhale to down dog split, exhale, bend the right knee, open the hip. You can stay if you want to. You're welcome to flip the dog. It's your choice. Otherwise, you're welcome to just stay in scorpion dog. Those of you that chose to flip, come back to scorpion dog. Re-straighten that right leg as you inhale, and as you exhale, step to the top of the mat. Seal your left heel down, and we're meeting in a warrior two. So windmill those arms all the way open to warrior two. So we had this similar shape earlier in the gate pose with the knee down, so now we're standing on both feet. Really press into the outer edge of your left foot. Deep bend in that right knee. You should be taking up most of your mat, particularly if you've got your long legs. Keep the shoulders away from the ears, biceps, triceps engaged. Keep the lower belly drawing in and up, stay connected to that core. Take an inhale, tall spine. As you exhale, take your hands in prayer, angle your left toes left, and bend your left knee as deeply as you can into a side lunge. And then use your legs, inhale, come back to a warrior two. Let's do that four more times. Exhale, side lunge, inhale, warrior two. Exhale, side lunge, inhale, warrior two. Two more, exhale, and inhale. One more, exhale, and inhale. Now stay for the exhale. The inhale is a reverse warrior, reach up and back. And as you exhale, on this next exhale, you're coming right into half moon. So as you exhale, you'll plant your right hand outside of the right foot and you'll lift up onto one leg and find your balance. Flex your left foot and extend through that left heel, or some of you might be able to bend the knee and grab for the top of the foot for Tripassana, the bind. Whatever feels best in your body today. If you took the bind, start to slowly re-extend your left leg. Take an inhale. Listen, we're coming into twisted half moon. So as you exhale, the left hand will come down and you're just gonna switch. You're gonna reach the right arm up and you're coming into that twist. You're still balanced. Opening the chest towards the right. Keep the belly pulling in and up and stay connected to your breath. Take one more inhale. Listen, as you exhale, start to bend your right knee and bring your left foot to meet your right, and hands in prayer, hook the left elbow outside of the right knee, and you're in a twisted chair pose. Don't do this. Don't have those hips up. You want the hips lower than the heart. Palms pressed nice and tight. If you've got variations that you know, you're welcome to take them. I'm just gonna stay right here in the modification, hands in prayer. Inhales to lengthen, exhales to twist. Finish your next exhale, take an inhale, and then as you exhale, fold over the legs, Uttanasana. Halfway lift, inhale, lengthen your spine, and then exhale once again, fold over the legs. Switching sides, chair pose, inhale, bend the knees, sweep the ground, get low, and then exhale, hands in prayer, and you'll twist to the left. So chair pose on the other, twisted chair on the other side. All right, from this twisted chair, we are going to add on. So shift the weight into the left foot, pick up your right toes, hover. And go nice and slow as you inhale, extend the right leg back. And as you exhale, pull it back in, knee to knee. Nice and slow, inhale, extend. Exhale, pull it in. We've just got three more, inhale to extend. Exhale, pull it in. Two more, inhale. And exhale. One more, inhale. And exhale. This time, step that right foot all the way back and we'll meet in a twisted lunge here. If you need to, you can lower that back knee down at any point in time, no problem. Keep the hands pressing in prayer at your heart, or some of you might choose to fly the arms, it's up to you. Stay with your breath, keep that back leg engaged if the knee is off of the mat. On your next exhale, take your hands down and come into a runner's lunge, lengthen your heart forward, inhale, and as you exhale, straighten that left leg and fold into extended pyramid pose. Just getting a nice little stretch here. Some of you might even want to flex the foot if it feels good. You can put the back heel down, or if your hamstrings are really tight, it's fine to keep the back heel up. Listen to your body. Last exhale here. As you inhale, halfway lift, lengthen your spine. As you exhale, re-bend that left knee, take your fingertips in front of the left foot. Our next movement is a standing split Shiva squat back to this low lunge. So you'll lift off, right leg high, standing split, knee to knee Shiva squat, standing split, and then all the way back down to your low lunge. Got it? We're going to do this a total of 8 times. So we've got 7, squat, split, and down. 6, squat, split, and down. 5, squat, split, and down. Last 4, squat, split, and down. Last 3, split, squat, split, and down. 2 more, lift, squat, split, come down. Last 1, take it up, pull it in, take it up, and back to that low lunge. Take an inhale, lengthen your spine. As you exhale, shorten your stance and again, straighten that left leg. But I want you to take a shorter stance this time. If you've got a block at home, you're welcome to use your block. Twisted triangle. Plant the right hand inside or outside of your left foot and twist open. Reach that left arm up. Lots of twisting today. If it feels okay on your neck, you can take your gaze up. I've got the sun in my eyes, so I'm just gonna keep my gaze out to the side. Every inhale, a little more length. Every exhale, a little more twist. Take one more exhale. Gaze to your toes. As you inhale, you're gonna windmill the arms open, toes in, heels out. I'll turn so you can see me. Hands to the hips. Lift the chest, inhale, look up and fold forward as you exhale into Pasarita. Hands to the mat, fingertips in line with your toes. Take a half lift, inhale, and then fold over those legs. As you exhale, you can walk the hands as far back between the legs as you would like. Pressing into the balls of the feet, keeping the belly drawing in and up, staying with the breath. Finish your next exhale here. As you inhale, halfway lift, hands to the hips. As you exhale, stand all the way up, bring your heels in, toes out, and sit low into a goddess pose with the hands in prayer. Little pulses for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Listen, 3, 2. On 1, take those hands behind the head. Take an inhale, tall spine. As you exhale, tap right elbow to the right knee, back to center, and then left to left. Center, right and up, left and up. Keep going, right and up, left and up, right, left. Let's go 3 more rounds, right and up, left and up. 2 more, right, left. Last one, right and left. Good job, come back to center. Sit as low as you can, hands in prayer, and then burst open to star pose. Hands to hips, bring your toes back in, heels out. You'll turn to face the top of your mat. And then it's your choice here. You can either grab opposite elbows or take a reverse prayer. Take an inhale, lengthen, and then exhale, you fold into this pyramid pose variation. I want you to take a shorter stance. So this is not extended pyramid pose, this is a shorter stance. Hip square off to the top of the mat, fold forward. Great, good work. Slowly release your grip, whether it's the prayer hands or the opposite elbows, hands forward, inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, come into a low lunge, plant your palms and move through a vinyasa. However you want to get to down dog, it's up to you. You can step back, you can skip it. We'll all meet up in downward facing dog and we'll start that same sequence again from the top. So really reset in this down dog, connect to the breath. And then we'll lift the left leg high to the sky, down dog split. As you exhale, it's the 3-limbed plank first, and then back to down dog split, and then it's knee to nose. 4 more. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. 3 more. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. 2 more, inhale, exhale, Inhale, exhale. Last, inhale, exhale, inhale, and exhale. Inhale, lift that left leg up and back. Exhale, bend the left knee and open the hip. You can either stay or you can flip the dog if you like to take that back then. No worries, listen to what your body needs. And then as you inhale, if you've flipped, come back to the scorpion dog. We'll meet in a down dog split, left leg high, inhale. And as you exhale, step to the top of the mat. Seal your right heel down and windmill those arms open and find your Virabhadrasana 2. Warrior 2, get yourself set up. If you need to make any adjustments, do that. Heel to heel or heel to arch alignment. Press deeply into the outer edge of your right foot. Big deep bend in your left knee. Don't lean forward. Make sure shoulders and hips are stacked center line. Strong straight arms. Gaze over those left fingertips. Keep drawing the belly in and up. Navel to your spine. All right, setting up for those side lunges. Inhale in Warrior 2. The exhale, you'll angle your right toes to the right a little bit. Bend the right knee as deeply as you can. Flex your left foot. And then inhale, come back to the Warrior 2. Four more. Exhale. And inhale. Three more. Exhale. And inhale. Two more. Exhale. And inhale. Last. Exhale and inhale. Stay for your exhale. Keep that bend of the knee. Inhale, reach up and back. Reverse the warrior. And then we exhale into half moon, Ardha Chandrasana. So right into it. Left hand outside of that left foot. Right leg lifts high. And if you want it, you can bend the right knee and grab the top of the foot for that bind, Shavasana. Listen to your body. Breathe into it, and nice and slow, we'll transition. If you have the bind, re-extend the leg, take that right hand down, and come into twisted half moon. So reaching the left arm up, keeping that right leg strong and engaged, finding that twist. Take one more breath in, and as you exhale, start to bend your left knee. Bring the right foot to meet the left and take your hands in prayer. Hook the right elbow outside of your left knee, twisted chair pose. Pausing to breathe. Every inhale, a little more length. Every exhale, a little more twist. Make sure your hips are low. Palms press into each other at heart center. One more inhale, lengthen. One more exhale, twist. And then take a breath in, and then as you exhale, it's a forward fold at the top of the mat, Uttanasana. Halfway lift, inhale, and fold as you exhale. One more like that, halfway lift, inhale, fold as you exhale, and then we'll come into twisted chair on the other side. So bend the knees, start in chair pose, inhale, exhale, hands in prayer, lengthen as you inhale, twist as you exhale. Shift the weight into that right foot, pick up your left toes, hover. We do this 5 times, go slow. Inhale, extend that left leg long, and then exhale, pull it back in knee to knee. Nice and slow, inhale, extend. Exhale, pull it in. Last 3, inhale, and exhale. Last 2, inhale, and exhale. Last 1, inhale and exhale. Now we'll land in the lunge. So inhale, step it back, and this time land the left toes down and find your lunge. Lower the back knee if you need support, no problem. Please listen to what your body needs. Palms pressing. If the back knee is up, don't sink the hips down, really engage that back leg. If you're feeling good and you want to fly the arms, you can. Otherwise, just keep the hands pressing in prayer at your heart center. Great job, everyone. A few more cycles of breath. On your next exhale, bring your hands down, frame that right foot, lengthen the heart forward, inhale, and as you exhale, extended pyramid pose. Again, if you need to, you can stay on the ball of the back foot. It's a nice wide stance, but if you've got very flexible hamstrings, some of you might even want to flex the front foot if you need a little more stretch. Slow down your breath if you lost it. Again, make sure you're connected to Ujjayi the entire time. Replant the foot if you had it lifted. Take a half lift, inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, rebend your right knee so you're in that lunge. We're doing this 8 times, the standing split to Shiva squat, back to low lunge. Fingertips forward. Lift up as you inhale, standing split. Knee to knee, exhale, Shiva squat. Inhale up, exhale all the way back to that low lunge. 7 more, split, squat, split, and down. 6, squat, split, and down. 5, squat, split, and down. 4, squat, split, and down. Last 3, squat, split, and down. Last 2, squat, split, and down. We've got 1 more, lift it up. Take the curtsy, lift it up, and then all the way back down. Take an inhale here. Shorten your stance as you exhale. Bring that left foot in. Again, straighten your right foot. Setting up twisted triangle. So hips are squared off, and then the left hand is inside or outside of your right foot, and that right arm reaches up. If you want to, you can take the gaze up. That's very traditional in the practice. Every inhale, a little more length. Every exhale, a little more twist. Take 1 more exhale. Shift the gaze to your big toe mound if you haven't already. And as you inhale, you'll windmill the arms open and find the wide-legged stance, toes in, heels out. I'll turn so you can see me. This time, interlock all 10 fingers behind you. Squeeze the palms. As you inhale, lift the chest, look up. And as you exhale, take a forward fold and enjoy this nice shoulder stretch here, Pajarita C. No tension in the head or neck, just let the head and neck be heavy. The breath is steady and smooth. Next exhale, listen, take your hands to the lower back, release the bind and hands to hips. Inhale with a flat back, come up halfway, and then exhale, come up the rest of the way. All right, 1 more thing here before we make our way to the top of the mat. Take your arms up. Inhale, tall spine. As you exhale, I want you to take a hinge halfway down. Move the upper body to the left, come all the way back up to center, and then hinge forward to the right, all the way back up to center. I want you to focus on keeping the belly tight and a tall spine. We've got 4 more. Hinge, left, up to center. Hinge, right, up, center. 3 more. Hinge, left, come up, center. Hinge, right, come up to center. Last 2. Hinge, left, up, hinge, right, come up. Just 1 more. Hinge to the left, come up, hinge to the right, come up. Good job. Hands to hips, and then turn on your heels to face back to the top of the mat. So I'm obviously going to be turning to face the opposite way, but it's just because I am doing my right side. You should be at the top of your mat on your right leg. So turn on the heels, shorten your stance a little bit, square off the hips, and then you have the option to grab opposite elbows, or you can take reverse prayer. Take an inhale, tall spine, and then as you exhale, you'll fold forward over that right leg to the best of your ability. And breathe, think chin to shin. Finish your next exhale, release whatever grip you had. Hands to the mat, lengthen your spine. Inhale, exhale, rebend your right knee, and then you'll move through your vinyasa, or you'll skip it. We're meeting in a down dog either way, so you can step back, you can flow. Whatever works for you, and we'll meet in a downward facing dog. Reset the breath. smooth it out. All right, we've got one more thing here before we cool it down. Roll out to a plank pose as you inhale, and then come down onto your forearms for a forearm plank. Bring your big toes together so they touch, and we're gonna tap the knees down and up without letting the pelvis move, down and up. So don't let your hips move, just tap the knees down and up, down and up, down and up. Keep going, down and up. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, listen, we're not done. On one, you have the option to stay, hold forearm plank, or mountain climbers in forearm plank. Right knee, right tricep, left knee, left tricep. Let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, to Sphinx pose. Good job, hips down. Release the interlock of the hands, press your forearms into the mat. Slow down the breath. Great job, everyone. All right, let's take a floor back bend here. We'll take a locust pose. Salavasana. So we'll take a variation where your arms are out wide like airplane wings. If you can, bring your big toes together so they touch, and then you'll lift everything up. Try to get your fingertips in line with the crown of the head. Keep your gaze down so your neck stays nice and long. Hold it for 5. Breathe for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release. We'll meet in a downward facing dog. If you need to pass through a child's pose, you can. Otherwise, you can press up to plank and lift the hips up and back, down dog. Right leg up to the sky, inhale. As you exhale, bend the right knee, open the hip. If it feels nice, again, you have the option to flip the dog. It might feel nice here at the end of the practice to take that back bend. Back to scorpion dog. Straighten the right leg, bring your right knee to your right wrist for single-legged pigeon. So, before you collapse into this shape, because I know it feels really good, I want you to make sure that your hips are squared. That's number one. If you're not feeling much in your outer hip, you can bring your right shin more parallel to the top of the mat. But if that means your left hip starts to do this, bring that right foot in closer. The most important thing is hip square. Make sure that left leg is exactly back behind you. If you've got a block at home, you can take a block and set it underneath your right hip. And when you're ready, you'll walk forward into your sleeping pigeon and breathe. You can rest your head on your forearms if you would like, or on your hands. Nice, slow, steady breaths here. Finish your next exhale, and then as you inhale, start to walk the hands back forward towards the upper body. Plant the palms down, and then you can move through a vinyasa or just step back to down dog. So if you want to, you can sweep that right leg up. You can flow. If you're done, you're done. Down dog, and let's just do that other side. So lift the left leg high to the sky. Bend the left knee, open the hip if you want it, and it's there for you. You can flip the dog, take that wild thing, and then come back around to the down dog split. Left knee to left wrist, setting up your single pigeon on the other side. Remember, most important thing, hips square. Don't let that right hip open. Block underneath the left hip is useful if you've got props at home. Left shin, the more parallel you get it, the deeper you'll feel this in your outer hip, but don't let it sacrifice the right hip coming off of the ground. When you're all set up and your form looks good, then you can start to come into your sleeping pigeon and enjoy this hip opener and breathe. really hear the breath in this shape. Smooth, steady inhales, slow, steady exhales. Finish your next exhale, and then as you inhale, start to walk the hands back towards your left shin, tuck your back toes. A final vinyasa if you want it. Move through your flow, or you can skip that and just come into your downward facing dog. From down dog, rise high onto the toes, step or jump the feet outside of the hands. Malasana squat. Don't worry, we're not doing any more standing up. Press the elbows into your inner thighs. Breathe, inhale. Breathe, exhale. Nice work, everyone. Start to walk the fingertips behind you. Sit those hips down. And we'll take Janushirasana here. Extend your left leg long. Bring the sole of your right foot inside of your left inner thigh. Reach both arms up. Inhale. And as you exhale, you'll fold over that left leg. If you need to bend the knee, no problem. Bend that left knee. Slow down the breath, still. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, release the foot. Take that left hand behind you. Lift onto your, take the right hand behind you. Lift onto your right shin and take a back bend. Reach that left arm up and over the ear. Maybe some big circles with that left arm to get some nice action in the shoulder. You can reverse and go the other way. And then when you're ready, hips down, and we'll just switch to the other side. Sole the left foot inside of the right leg, arms up, inhale, Janushirasana, exhale, fold. If you're very flexible, you can catch a wrist. If you're not so flexible, you can bend that right knee as much as you need to. It's just a nice forward fold here. Last exhale. As you inhale, halfway lift. As you exhale, release the foot. Left hand behind you this time. Point your right toes. Stand on that left shin. Stretch. Take that nice back bend again. And if you want to, big sweeping circles with that right arm. One direction, then the other. And then when you're ready, lower those hips back down. Take both legs forward. Flex the feet. Float the arms forward. Hollow the belly, use all that core strength from what we did earlier, lower down onto your back. And I do not like to skip back bends, so we're going to take just two back bends here today. You can choose to take two bridges or a bridge and a wheel. Bring your feet hips width distance apart. Fingertips are pretty close to brushing the heels. Keep the belly in to support the low spine and slowly peel your hips up off of the mat for bridge pose. If you want to, you can interlock all 10 fingers underneath the lower back. Imagine you had a block between the knees, so squeeze the block energetically. Breathe for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release the interlock of the hands. Curl your spine down nice and slow, one vertebra at a time. Breath in. Breath out, and then the last back bend is all you. It can be the same thing we just did, or if you've got a wheel in your practice, you can take the hands by the ears, lift up onto the crown of the head, walk the hands underneath the shoulders, and then lift up into your full wheel. Your choice, bridge or wheel. Hold it for 5. Breathe for 4. Keep the belly in for 3, 2, 1. If you were in wheel, tuck the chin and slowly come out. And everyone in Supta Baddha Konasana, soles of the feet together and the knees wide. One hand to the heart, one hand to the belly. And just pause to let everything settle in, to slow down. A appreciating the body, appreciating the breath. And then when you are ready, final Savasana is waiting for you. If you have any closing shapes that you need, you're welcome to take them. If you need a twist, if you need a happy baby, maybe you rest here a little bit longer in Supta Baddha Konasana. This is a really nice, gentle hip opener. So I'll give you about a minute to kind of complete your practice in your own way. And then find your final resting pose when you're ready. So the legs extend long in Savasana, the arms by the sides, palms facing up. Now you release any control over the breath. Let the body receive the practice in stillness. We started from a place of stillness, we end from a place of stillness. Close the eyes down and just melt into your mat. So you're welcome to stay in this final Savasana for as long as you need. If you'd like to finish in a comfortable seat the way we began, you can start to deepen the breath and wiggle the fingers, wiggle the toes, bring little bits of movement back into the physical body. Maybe rock the head side to side a few times, maybe roll out your ankles one direction than the other, the wrists. Maybe stretch the arms over the head and take a nice waking up stretch, whatever feels best for you. And then you can roll onto your right or to your left side. Or if it feels better, you can also just rock up to a comfortable seat. Choosing either the same position that you began, or maybe you have a different comfortable seat, just make sure once again the spine is stretched nice and tall to the ceiling or the sky. Eyes closed. A moment in stillness. And then please bring your hands in prayer at your heart center, Anjali Mudra. Bow the chin to the chest, honoring your body, your breath, and your practice today. Remember, the body and the mind are different every day. The practice will look a little bit different every day. You all worked very hard. Thank you for sharing your energy with me. Namaste.